Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to discuss, as I said, some sums on Bayes theorem. So this is the first sum. A man is known to speak truth 3 out of 4 times. He throws a die and reports that it's a 6. Find the probability it is actually a 6. So first, if I take E1 event as die show 6, E1 event if I will take as die show 6, and E2 event if I will take that it doesn't show 6. So first E1 event that it shows 6 and E2 event it doesn't show 6. So first case that we know that probability of E1. What is the probability of getting a 6? If I throw a die, that is 1 divided by 6. So what is probability of E2? That will be obviously 5 divided by 6. Because it doesn't show 6, it will be 5 divided by 6. So first case that if I will take the event A, that man reports that 6 has occurred. So A is the case where the person report the 6 has occurred. So for that case, what is probability of A given E1? That he is reporting 6 and it's a 6. That means he is speaking the truth. So, speaking the truth, probability is given that 3 divided by 4. Probability that he is reporting a 6, but it doesn't show a 6. So, that means he is not speaking truth, right? So, that will be 1 minus 3 by 4, that is 1 divided by 4. Now, what we need to find out? We need to find out that it's actually a 6 and it's coming from his report. Actually 6 coming from his report, that is E1 by A. So we know E1 by A into probability of A, that will be equals to probability of E1 into probability of A given E1, right? So if I just put the value, probability of this is 1 divided by 6, this is 3 divided by 4, and what is probability of A? It is 1 divided by 6 into 3 divided by 4 plus 5 divided by 6 into 1 divided by 4. So if I will just calculate this, I will get the answer as 3 divided by 8, right? So if I move to the next sum, I hope all of you understood this thing. Please go thoroughly. Next sum, if I move, in a test, an examinee either guess or copies or knows the answer. So first case, if I will take that E1 as for guess, E2 as for copies, and E3, he knows the answer, right? So it's given that probability that he makes a guess, that is 1 divided by 6. Probability that he copies, that is 1 divided by 9. Probability he copies, these things you need to write. So probability of he knows the answer, it's not given, right? So for attempting the question, what are the options he has? He either has to guess or needs to copies or he needs to know the answer, right? So that means these three events are mutually exclusive and exhaustive event. So can we write that probability of E1 plus probability of E2 plus probability of E3, that is equals to 1? So 1 divided by 6 plus 1 divided by 9 plus probability of E3, that will be equals to 1. So probability of E3 is equals to 1 minus 1 divided by 6 minus 1 divided by 9. So if I will simplify, I will get 11 divided by 18. Am I doing it correctly? 18 minus 3 minus 2, yes. No, the calculation mistake was there. So the actual answer is 13 divided by 18. So let me change this. This will be 13 divided by 18. That is probability of E3. Now, next case that probability that the answer is correct given that he copied it. Copy was E2. So if I will take this A as correct answer. A stands for correct answer. So probability of correct answer, he copied answer, right? That is equals to given 1 divided by 8. Now what is probability of A given E3? E3 was he knows the answer. If he knows the answer, so it's expected that he will answer it correctly. So this answer will be equals to 1. Right? Okay. Now, one more thing, that guess. Now, it is given that there are 4 choices are there. So 4 choices are there. From there, if he needs to make a guess, so probability that the answer is correct with guess, that is equals to 1 divided by 4. Right? So now, what we need to find out? We need to find out probability that he knows the answer, probability he knows the answer, given that he answered it correctly. So probability of he knows the answer, that is P3, given that he answered it correctly, that we need to find out, right? So now, probability of E3 given A, that will be equals to into probability of A will be over here, and the numerator part, it will be probability of E3 into probability of A given E3, right? So what is probability of E3? That will be 13 divided by 18 into, this is 1, divide by, if we find out probability of A, what will be probability of A? Let's find out probability of A separately. So probability of A will be probability of A given E1 into probability of E1 plus probability of A given E2 into probability of E2 plus probability of A given E3 into probability of E3. So if I just calculate and put the value over there, it will be 13 divided by 18 into 1 plus 1 divided by 9 into 1 divided by 8 plus 1 divided by 6 into 1 divided by 4. So if I'll calculate, I will get 1 divided by 18 in the numerator, and denominator it will be 13 divided by 18, and this is 13 divided by 18. So if I'll calculate, this will be the answer, 13 divided by 14. So if I move to the next sum, a bag contains 4 balls. Balls are drawn at random. So how I can draw 2 balls from 4 balls? That can be done by 4C2, right? And 2 balls are drawn at random and found to be white. What's the probability that all balls are white? So now, first case E1, there are 2 balls, 2 white balls and 2 non-white balls. Second case E2, there are 3 white ball means 1 non-white ball, right? And third case E3, there are 4 white balls and 0 non-white ball. Because as I have to draw 2 white balls, so minimum number of white ball has to be 2 over there, right? So what is the probability of E1? E1 case 1 by 3, same guess with E2 and same guess with E3. So what I am taking, the first case, the ball is coming from the first cases, ball is coming from the second case, second event or third event. Probability of first event, probability of second event, probability of third event, all are equal, that is 1 by 3, right? Now first case, that probability of A given E1, that the 2 balls are coming from the first bag. So that case it will be 2C2, divided by 4C2, so answer is 1 divided by 6. Second case, the white ball is coming from the second bag. So second bag I have 3 white balls, right? So 3C2 out of this 4C2. So that probability is equals to 1 divided by 2. And the final case is there are all white balls. So probability of white ball from the third case, that will be equals to 1. So now we need to find out that it's all white up there. So we need to find out probability of E3 given A. Divide by probability of A, it will be there. Numerator, it will be probability of E3. Into probability of A given E3. So now if I put all the values, I will get it like, so that will be the answer. So that's it for now. So Bayes theorem we have done only 3-4 sums, but there are many more sums in Bayes theorem. Just practice and let me know if there is any doubt. Thank you all of you.